If you're experiencing some kind of pain somewhere inside your body, don't Google it. Chances are, it will probably tell you you have Ebola, cancer, and arthritis all at the same time. But is it possible to get a diagnosis online? Definitely yes, if you consult a doctor. But in this channel, we try to ask questions about how the future will look like based on what the present looks like. So today, we raise a big question. Will internet be able to tell our diagnosis just by tracking our activity? Hi, I am Jonka. Welcome to Blank Notes. First of all, we have to know that every single click or mouse hovering is monitored. Big tech companies track all our online activities and they gather data, which will then be sold to the highest bidder. If you didn't know, yes, they do. That's how they make the money. That's how they know you want to buy a new laptop. So, the theory is that, as our everyday lives become inseparable from the digital one, in the near future, every single step will leave a track. Data-gathering companies know our routines, our shopping list, our location, and so on. And if studied for long periods of time, that data can tell a lot for our health, physical and mental. Basically, when your doctor asks about your life, he is not trying to get intimate. He wants to know what your body goes through. Smartphones are now extensions of our bodies. Combined with other gadgets, they know exactly when we go to sleep and when we wake up, therefore sleep schedule. Gadgets do know how many days you work, what means of transport you use, do you drive or do you commute, what kind of job you have, do you sit down, do you move a lot, do you go to the gym or not, your steps, your heart rate, and therefore physical activity. They know your profession, your money situation, and also work environment. So, in theory, even the level of stress can be calculated, to some extent. And lastly, your shopping habits. It may seem unthinkable that there is somebody behind the screen calculating how much nutrition you take in, knowing each and every ingredient there is in the food you are eating. And you're right. Nobody in their sane mind would give a man such a task. But they would definitely give it to a computer. And of course, feeding your symptoms, past or present, to the internet is absolute gold. The medicine you order, vitamins you need, drugs you prefer. You can be sure that a record of your health history is definitely stored in some folder, in some hard drive that you have no idea about. Now, of course, even if they would know every single detail of what we mentioned before, the assumptions would be vague, and they would still face three issues. Families. Assuming that one of the biggest factors to be monitored will be the shopping list, food and utilities, the data will remain in household funds. Sure, based on age, gender and lifestyle, the system could try to assume. But the science wouldn't be exact. Unless we personally feed the system with every intake, it will be impossible to divide family members. Non-digital side activities. Life at this stage is still pretty detached from the digital one. There is still cash services. Not everybody uploads gym routines, field trips, headaches, chest pains, and surely not everybody has an Apple Watch. We are not yet feeding every second of our lives to the cloud. Not yet. Unification of services. This is probably the biggest out of the three, as the line between search engine, service hardware providers, and money institutions becomes thinner by the leaders of big tech, having a private life fades more and more. But depending on where you live and your life habits, you definitely use different companies for different needs. So the records would still miss the full picture of your life. But just think about it. Your iPhone knows when you wake up, when you clocked in, what was the road to there like, what you surfed the net for. Apple Watch knows your heart rate, whether you exercised. Apple Music knows every mood swing of yours, and finally, Apple Pay knows what and when you are eating. And with all that data tracking stored, serious opinion will definitely matter. So, will there be a need to go to the doctor? Yes and no. Software is trying hard. You would be surprised to know how far machine learning and AI has gone into interpreting x-rays and other diagnostics. But that still requires going to the clinic. Data tracking can only do so far. Perhaps brain chips will do it. But will lifestyle monitoring take a place in how we will approach health? That is for sure going to happen. That's all for today. Catch you in the next one.